So now we are going to discuss about the reversible process. There are two processes will be exist to explain about the Carnot engine. Okay, first one is reversible process, next one is irreversible process. Okay, first we'll see about the reversible process. What is the reversible? Very important. This is useful for in the Carnot cycle. What is the reversible process? Okay, a process that can be retraced back in opposite direction. The process that can be retraced means we can get back in opposite direction is called reversible process. So understood, a process that can be retraced back in opposite direction is called reversible process. Okay, there are many examples. Let us take examples. Okay, first example we can take fusion of ice, vaporization of water. Fusion of ice and vaporization of water. Okay, then one more example also is there. Then this friction example also we can give. So this is the first one, reversible process. The process that can be retraced means we can get back, that it should be in opposite direction is called a reversible process. Okay, there are many examples are there. First one is fusion of ice and vaporization of water. So another also it is there, effect, this filter effect and seebeck effect also we can say. See, back, it will come in the second year. Okay, this is about the reversible process. Next one, irreversible process. Irreversible process. Definition. What is the definition? A process that cannot be retraced back in opposite direction is called irreversible process. Okay, here also we can give some examples. Okay, first one, okay, what is the first one? Work done against the friction. Next one, yes. Okay, see, what is the irreversible process? The process cannot be retraced back in opposite direction is called irreversible process. Example, work done in against the friction. Next, diffusion of gases. Okay, these are the very important use for in the Carnot engine. Okay, so Carnot engine, if you want to run, we need these two processes. One is reversible process, another one is irreversible process. Okay, most of the in the Carnot engine we are using the reversible process. Okay, in the Carnot engine, why we are using this reversible process means there are, okay, let us take gas is there. The gas is working in the different temperatures. The temperature, T1 temperature to T2 temperature. One condition to another condition. Then we can say that is the that principle we can use in the Carnot cycle. Okay, if you want to understand about the Carnot engine means you should understand first to the reversible process. The process that can be retraced back means we can get back, then we can say that is the reversible process. That case we are using the what is the Carnot engine. For that we are going to derive the equation for Carnot engine. Then how much efficiency the Carnot engine is working, that we are going to see now.